Welcome back. The program is not just a woman on set. We are joined by Honorable Anne Lagat. She is a nominated member of County Assembly, Uasin Gishu County. She's an entrepreneur. She's a mother. She's a wife. She's all these amazing things, and she's able to juggle them all together at once. You're the ultimate multitasker. Before we went on a break, I had asked you a question that said, how are things different from how you used to run businesses to now being a politician? If you can just articulate in your own words.
Rose, it's really been a new experience altogether, and because I'm one person who is a go-getter, it's been a beautiful experience because it calls for rising so highly as five, then have time to pray because I believe in prayer. For God to fix things for you, you must start with God.
Okay.
And by six I'm in school, I run a school, and by six I'm in school, I'm yet to check up on the program, receive children when they arrive. Personally, I love babies. I stayed for 6 years without children, 7 years without children, and when God blessed me, He blessed me abundantly. So I see the children in school, I receive them, and I meet the teachers for briefing, and I tell them to kick off. Then I attend to the people who come to see me. It's women, if there's any program they need to they need clarification on, like government program.
Right.
We have so many government programs
running.
Then we have also meetings, committee sittings. I sit in the committee of trade, and we deliberate so many things that affect the county. I also sit in the committee of environment.
Okay.
I'm very sensitive on environment, and it's good to conserve environment. And I also give my input in that committee. I also sit the vice chair of the rules and procedure committee at the county assembly, and we also have parliament sittings that we do it on Tuesday afternoon, the whole Wednesday, and Thursday afternoon.
Okay. Well, I always asking, Mheshimiwa, you have been in this position. What are your achievements? What have you done that you can be remembered for? Whether you want to vie for another position, you want to continue the same position, what is it that you have done to be worthy, you know, of the position of member of county assembly, Uasin Gishu?
Rose, I'll start with the legislation. Yeah, we've put in, given that devolution is a new concept that first came. When we came, we took so much time training, and I would say we've passed legislation that have really been able to support women.
Okay.
Yeah, and we've come up with programs as county, like we have a rehabilitation program. Because of food insecurity, I followed up the challenges that women go through. When children sleep hungry, it's a burden to every woman, not even a man, woman. And I've been able to make a follow-up and see the challenges that women go through from food insecurity. Most of them have done illegal things that have landed them in prison.
Okay.
Still in prison, we have challenges, and we have a program, a foundation called Sisters Comfort, where sisters of like-minded have come together to help women in prison. We give them pads, we take pampers. We also have children in prison because the women who commit crimes and because they are expectant, they ended up delivering in prison. Some have small babies, they have nobody to leave their children behind with, and the children run in prison. So we've been able to mobilize the community to give us funding. The government have also supported us in Nandi. And above that, when I did a survey, I said prison program is not enough. The root cause was, why did this woman land in prison? It's because of the illegal thing they did, and we've gone back to the society, and we have a program for rehabilitating alcohol brewers.
Okay.
Majority are brewers, and we've been working with them, training them. Personally, I have a background in consultancy, and my key thing I would say I've done is consultancy and mentor them.
Okay.
Mentorship is my passion, and I have a hobby of making money. I also help them to make money in a rightful way, so that they don't even land in the hands of government for the wrong reasons.
Okay.
Yes.
I have to ask, do you see yourself going for a position of election? Do you want to be elected now? Still a member of county assembly? Do you want to go for the Senate seat? Are you still in the political field, or is this it?
Rose, I tried politics, and I've been in it for 4 years. I've seen the good things in it and the bad things in it. I personally am a believer, and one day I want to make it to heaven. And Rose, I would pay the price it takes to make it to heaven, because that is eternity. I would want to give my time to the community. But in politics or not in politics, I can still do it.
Okay.
Because I believe I have what it takes. Currently, I'm not fighting for any seat, but my passion for women will continue. because I would want to consult and help even government agencies on areas to improve on devolution.
And you're the first person who I've seen enter into politics and want to come out. Usually when people go into politics, they want to stick around. They don't want to ever leave. Why is this so? What are some of the lessons you have learned?
I am a unique woman, and I'm not a slave of anybody.
Okay.
And I'm not a slave of any lifestyle. Being a politician was an opportunity for me to be there to learn so many things. Mm-hmm. And I've been hearing what goes on in politics, but personally I've been there.
Mm-hmm.
It's not easy to run government. Mm-hmm. I feel for the leaders, and especially with devolution.
Mm-hmm.
The
mm-hmm.
offices that have been put in place, the governor's office, the Senate, the women rep position,
mm-hmm.
and the things that are in those offices.
Okay.
We are used to an MP who has CDF, who has goodies, and here comes an office of women rep, which to me, I feel it really has to be structured.
Mm-hmm.
The needs of women are too much,
okay.
but you find that office doesn't have a lot. It okay. has to be restructured.
Okay.
It has to be empowered.
Mm-hmm.
And it is too big. Look
are
at what's in issue
it's crippled?
Count.
Are you saying we have been given the women rep position, but it's crippled?
No, we appreciate, but that is I appreciate the position of women, because mm-hmm. women now we have a voice.
Okay.
And I've been mentoring and challenging so women to join politics.
Okay.
Because but representation is very key, and these resources must be shared equally. We need a voice that will say, please, more resources to women.
Mm-hmm.
And it is a male-dominated society,
mm-hmm.
and in leadership it's about the numbers.
Okay.
Because if you have a very nice bill or motion that must be passed, mm-hmm. it's about numbers.
Mm-hmm.
So yes, I'm encouraging so many women to come on board. Let okay. them fight. Personally, I'll be there to give them moral support.
Mm-hmm.
I'll be there to consult to consult for them even for free.
Okay.
Currently, that's what I'm doing.
Okay.
And also, I did a survey and a research based on devolution
mm-hmm.
and areas that we need to improve, and I'll be able to present the paper to government
okay.
on the loopholes that we can seal to mm-hmm. make sure that devolution becomes real.
Okay.
So I would want to be a government advisor.
All right.
Yes.
So you'd want to go back to consulting, which is where
yes.
you actually began from.
Thank you.
I want to ask this question. In your own words, what are some of the challenges that you met that you did not anticipate before you went into your position? Because sometimes we promise a lot of things that we don't actually fulfill, and people are angry at us because we said we'll do many things, and then we find that the system really isn't so cooperative to enable you achieve what you wanted to achieve. What are your frustrations? That's what I'm asking.
What is right may not be politically right. That is what I learned. You can come with a good idea which is looking so good,
mm-hmm.
but when you seek the political interpretation,
mm-hmm.
it is the worst idea. That is the frustration I got in politics.
Yes.
Yeah. But, and also people's opinion.
Mm-hmm.
You can come up with a nice idea that requires you to lobby, to negotiate with others,
mm-hmm.
even a good thing that looks so good, and you really take a lot of your time negotiating. People will tell you, what are you doing for us to support you?
Mm-hmm.
They still want something in return, and it's a good thing that is going to help everybody.
Okay.
So that is the frustration you go through, because an idea that you think is going to help the community,
mm-hmm.
it will improve their life,
mm-hmm.
lifestyle,
mm-hmm.
and here somebody is telling you, no, convince me enough, yes, talk to me nicely, and that is what the frustration I really went through.
Okay.
Yes.
Comment on the leadership even as you exit.
Yes.
Do you think we have a strong leadership going forward? This is an election year. Many other people will be going into the field and asking for votes. Do you think we have leaders doing what they're supposed to do? You had a bird's eye view of everything that was happening around you.
Yeah, Wasingishu issue as a county, I would say we've done great. And with the leadership of our governor, Mandago,
mm-hmm.
we've really done a lot.
Okay.
And setting structures for a new government is not easy. Mm-hmm. Bringing people on board who are going to support government,
mm-hmm.
ministries running,
mm-hmm.
it's really not been easy. And also having the county assembly to legislate, because government cannot run without legislation,
mm-hmm.
so that the executive wing execute. It's really not been easy. But I would say we are one county that have moved forward.
Okay.
And it's my prayer that when leaders go out to seek re-election,
mm-hmm.
I pray that they put the interest of Kenyans ahead.
Okay.
First of all, we need peace.
Okay.
We need a peaceful election. We really don't want to go back to 2007.
Mm-hmm.
We are saying, let the leaders go out and amicably sell their agenda,
mm-hmm.
let them sell their manifesto.
Mm-hmm.
It is actually the common man who will decide depending on your manifesto. And also, I would say leaders don't over promise.
Okay.
Yeah, promise what you can deliver.
Yes.
Yeah, that is the big challenge because the common man is waiting to see. And above all, put God first because leaders come from God.
Okay.
Yes.
When I get women leaders on the show, I always ask them this question. It is very important for me. Do you think we have come to a point where leaders have been put at par with now their male counterparts as well? When it comes to running, when it comes to leadership, when it comes to respect and how you're treated, you know, in this arena? Or do you think it's still a man's game?
It's still a man's game, Rose. First of all, when they look at you as a woman and you have a good idea, they automatically would want to really eliminate you.
They feel threatened?
They feel threatened, actually, that are you coming so close and it's like you really have another agenda.
Okay.
So I will still tell women to really put on a brave face and stand for what they believe in, because that is my conviction. It's still a male-dominated world, because when you look at the numbers we elect, preference will be given to men. Look at America, a grown economy, but still they will not take a president woman.
And we don't have one governor who's female, one governor who's female. Does that tell us everything we need to be told?
I'm in my consultancy, Rose. My agenda is to bring women on board, tough women, to go and for such elective posts, even for governors.
Okay.
And it takes a bold woman. It also takes the support of other women. Mm-hmm. Actually, women, I would say, we're not supporting our fellow women.
Okay.
But if we really come out, that's the sensitization that I want to do. I've been telling every woman, believe in yourself and believe in your fellow woman.
Okay.
And that is, I think, where we should be able to come from. Mm-hmm. Because women are the people who vote.
Mm-hmm.
And if they decide to vote in a woman, oh, goodness me. It's only that we've had challenges, the women, the few women we've been able to elect, they've had challenges, they've become a letdown.
Okay.
And the other women are like, oh, better the man than the woman. Because women go through so many things when they can be branded badly, they can create a different image what they are not, and they really get affected, negative publicity, and some women will throw in the towel. But I tell women, put on the brave face, believe in God for your protection, and go for what you want.
Okay.
We will be having women governors, especially in this election.
Right.
I look forward for that.
That's a big dream.
It is, and it will come
for the first time.
It
will
come
to speak to young women who are coming up and they're aspiring to be leaders, whether it is at the MCA level, it's at the Senate level, you know, MP level, what would you say to a young woman who wants to go into leadership, given that you have been there and have a little bit of experience? What would you say to them? Should they shy away? Politics is for men?
No. I would tell them to give it a shot.
Mm-hmm.
And above all, character is what counts.
Okay.
Yeah. I want women of integrity, women who can stand for what they believe in, and women who cannot be compromised. Because men would want to compromise majority of them so that they step down for them. But I would tell them, go for what you believe in, and believe in God. It will come to pass.
Okay.
Yes, for any seat, give it a try.
Mm-hmm.
Because the people who've lost election first time, second time they lose, could be the third time people would feel, oh no, this is too much, and they would be re-elected.
Okay.
So they should not give up, whether with resources or without. You can come up with a strategy, so long as you are feasible. Yeah, mobility is key. Go to where people are and tell people your agenda. Kenyans are very good, and they are good listeners. They want to listen to your agenda.
Yes.
If it is nice and juicy, they will bite. But don't overpromise. Thank you.
What you cannot deliver.
Yes.
Or as we actually just come towards the end, I want to ask, what are your plans? We know that politics is not for you anymore, but what are your plans going forward? What do you have in store for the people coming forward? Because I think once a leader, always a leader. And I told you, this Mheshimiwa isn't going to leave just because you're leaving politics, and you show me it's a blessing and a curse. Maybe you can articulate about that. Why is it a blessing and a curse to be called Mheshimiwa? And then the plans you have going into the future.
The word Mheshimiwa, Rose, has come with its own price.
Okay.
Kenyans are made to believe that Mheshimiwa is a small Jesus who will sort out your issues, all your problems, from your kitchen to all the rooms. Mheshimiwa will, the name Mheshimiwa, you will sort all your issues.
Okay.
But let's believe that we are endowed as Kenyans, even as people of Uasin Gishu. And education is key, and business also. Let people, let children go to school, let students school, and use also their time wisely. Business is an opportunity that will give all of us a chance to make more money and make our home food secure and stable.
Okay.
But the mentality of a solution is in politics.
Okay.
should really not be the key thing.
Mm-hmm.
And let's appreciate what we can do as individuals,
mm-hmm.
because we are gifted differently.
Right.
And if we make use of our talents, let's discover what we are good at doing. Mm-hmm. If we do that and we network and we blend, I think we can make Kenya a small level on earth. Yeah, politics is not everything.
Okay.
So personally, I'm going back to consultancy, and I would want to work with different organizations,
mm-hmm.
more so government.
Okay.
I see the challenges government have gone through,
mm-hmm.
and have a few solutions. Given the research I've done, being in politics, there are areas I would want to advise government to improve on.
Mm-hmm.
That is my line, especially our county government.
Okay.
I'm impressed about the progress it has done so far,
okay.
and I think we can do better.
Okay.
Especially if we're able to re-elect our governor, because he has set good foundation, he can move on with that.
Okay.
Yes.
I want to thank you so much for coming to the show and joining us on the program. You are a delight to have. I'm hoping we can be able to have you in another forum.
I'll be more than willing to come again, Ross.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
That is it for today. My name is Rose Okinda. The program was Not Just a Woman. Until next week, we will be doing this again. From me to you, it's bye-bye on behalf of the crew here.